Hi everyone, how's it going? Welcome back to Cook Like a Japanese channel.
I'm Leo.
Today we're making shimmered right-eyed flounder or shimmered flatfish. You know, we call the flatfish curry in Japanese, and curry is one of the most popular fish here to shimmer. I believe shimmering is one of the most easiest way to cook fish, but the taste would be super yummy. So why don't we try making it? Alright, let's get started! Alright, the main ingredients for shimmered right-eyed flounder are only two. One is of course flounder fillet, and the other one is ginger. To make broth, we need soy sauce 2 tablespoons, sake 3 tablespoons, sugar 1 tablespoon, and a half cup of water. First, we need drop lid, but if you don't have one, you can make an instant one with aluminum foil. Well, we got 7 steps to make it. Step 1 is to remove the remaining scales of the fillet and make a shallow cut on it, like cutting the latex on it. You'll do it on the skin side. Step 2 is kusaminuki. It's quite similar to aburanuki that I've shown you in the Kitsune Udon movie. We do it to remove the unwanted fishy smell. You know, pour the shimmered water on it slowly and carefully. Try not to put the boiled water, because if the water you put was too hot, the skin of it would be break. Step 3 is to prepare the ginger. Peel the skin and cut them into matchsticks cut and set aside. We use it later for garnish. And we also use the removed skin when you shimmer the fish. Step 4 is to make the broth. You need soy sauce 2 tablespoons, 3 tablespoons of sake, plus sugar 1 tablespoon. Put them in a frying pan, mix and heat it for 2 to 3 minutes with medium heat. Then add a half cup of water, plus the ginger skin. Step 5 is to put the flounder fillet in the pan. Turn down the heat in a medium low and put the drop lid on, plus cover it with the real lid, then shimmer it for about 7 to 8 minutes. Step 6 is to remove the lid and ladle the broth on the fillet and shimmer it for another 2 to 3 minutes. Then plate it, put the garnish on, and it's ready. That's it! Why don't we go on to step 1? Alright, why don't we go on to step 1? Step 1 is to prepare the flounder fillet. Remove the scale if it's there. So why don't we put some letter X on it? Yeah, like this. What do we go on to step 2? Step 2 is kusaminuki. Now bring the water to boil. Before it's boiled, the water is heated. It's time to go. I put the fillet like this. You know, the water shouldn't be too hot. It goes like this. Okay. Upside down. Flip it over. Yeah, that's it. Okay. Why don't we go on to step 3? Alright, why don't we go on to step number 3? Step number 3 is to prepare the ginger. Cut the skin, and you need these skins when you shimmer the fillet. Just make it into matchstick size. Okay, now the ginger is ready, so set aside for garnish. Why don't we go on to step 4? Step 4 is to make broth. You'll start with sake 3 tablespoons, soy sauce 2 tablespoons, and with sugar 1 tablespoon. And then you get a stove on medium heat for 2 to 3 minutes. You know, be sure to mix it when you heat the broth. Alright, now 2 minutes has passed, so why don't we put a half cup of water? Okay, why don't we go on to step 5? You know, before you go to step 5, put the ginger skin in it. Turn down the heat to medium low and put the flounder fillet in the pan. Ladle the broth a bit Here you can make it instant chocolate with aluminum foil, like this toothpaste here, and put it on there. Plus, probably, it's the real me. It's gonna take 7 or 8 minutes, I guess. Right now, 7 minutes have passed, so why don't we go on to step 6? Step 6 is to remove the lid and the drop lid. Yeah, looks awesome, isn't it? Great. Lay the gloss on it and shimmer it for about another 2 to 3 minutes. Okay, looks awesome. Right now, another 2 minutes has passed, so why don't we play the Rider Flounder on a plate? Be careful, it's so fragile. Put the garnish on. Pour the broth on it. Yeah, it looks awesome. Alright, now shimmered Rider Flounder is ready now. Wow, looks awesome, isn't it? Alright, now you know how to make shimmered Rider Flounder, so why don't you try making it at your home? Anyway, thanks for watching, and please put some messages down below, put thumbs up button and subscribe. Okay, take good care. See you in the next video. Thank you. Arigato, bye bye.